Every year, more and more Americans are choosing to move abroad for retirement, and there's no sign of this trend slowing down. But before these people pack their bags or book their plane tickets, there's a few factors they might want to take into consideration. Here with me today is Ken Marief. He is the CEO of Retirement Planners of America. Ken, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me, Julie.
So what are some of those common missteps that retirees make when they're planning to spend their years abroad?
Well, you know, the thing about living abroad is that it's a romance thing.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes, you know, you fall in love and it's not necessarily the person that you should marry. And so there are some considerations that are practical that you need to think about if you're going to live abroad. One of the most important is your health care insurance.
Mm-hmm.
Medicare, if you live abroad, does not cover you. So if you go and live in France or somewhere else, remember, you're not going to be covered under Medicare. And while you are gone, make sure you continue to pay your Medicare Part B premiums because you may decide to come back. And if you do, you don't want your coverage to have lapsed.
So what are some other considerations that people can take on before retiring abroad?
Well, like I said, it's a romance,
mm-hmm.
okay? So one of the things that we encourage our clients to do is to practice before, you know, in other words, don't do it, don't commit to it, practice it first. So let's say that you decided you wanted to live in Provence, okay? So that you want to retire and go do that. Well, that sounds like a wonderful thing, right? You're in the country.
Like the sound of that,
you
yeah.
There's wine and it's wonderful and great, okay? Go get, you know, rent a place for a while, live there for a while,
mm-hmm.
practice it and see if you like it. You know, we've had clients that we've encouraged to do that. And what's happened is that they decided that being away from their kids
mm-hmm.
and their grandchildren, you know, it was inconvenient to travel back and forth.
Sure.
And, you know, you've got the exchange rate issues
mm-hmm.
with, you know, the dollar and the euro and bank accounts. Your investments are over here and over there. And healthcare is maybe not close by, and maybe you don't like it as much as U.S. healthcare, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So there are a lot of considerations. So practice it before you do it.
That's good advice. So Ken, thanks so much for being here.
You're welcome. Thank you.
And to learn more or to contact an advisor, visit rpoa.com. I'm Julie Parisi. See you again soon.